I remember when I first saw this when I was a teenager. I was like, whoa, he does seem like he's different than the other boys. But now as an adult, I'm like,
he's a sociopath. Run far away.
This movie is a movie full of people of questionable moral character, which makes it, in my opinion, maybe the best movie of all time. It is 1989's Heathers, which is a dark high school comedy about a girl who is a member of the popular clique but actually hates all of her friends and teams up with this kind of dark, gothy newcomer boy in her school to take them down, but it gets way out of hand. So let's talk about Heathers. First, I want to say this movie, as much as I love it and as perfect as I think the script is and how like hilarious and brutal and dark it is, could not be made today.
The last time I saw it, I mean, other than yesterday, was in the movie theater when it came out. And I saw it like 5 times in the movie theater, maybe 10 times. I loved it so much. I thought it was the most wonderful, brilliant thing that had hit the screen. It was pre-school shootings. So, you know, the idea of somebody blowing up their school and killing everybody in it was not something that I went to school every day worried about. So it was dark and it was unsavory, of course, but it was not, it wasn't exploiting like our biggest fears, you know, because that wasn't sort of on the menu. But it just takes the whole like, John Hughes kind of vibe and just turns it upside down on its head.
What I love is like it from the first scene, it starts out bizarrely. Like there's three girls named Heather, like berating each other.
It's your turn, Heather. Now, Heather, it's Heather's turn.
And every Heather knows when she's the Heather that's being addressed. There's never any, which Heather are you talking about? Like Heather Duke? Are you talking about this Heather? No.
And everybody in school knows too. Everybody just knows.
Yeah, every Heather knows which Heather they're talking about when they talk about the Heathers. One thing I also thought was like really brilliantly satirized in the movie is Veronica, played by Winona Ryder. I thought that the fact that she fell for JD, as played by Christian Slater, was a really funny commentary on the type of loser dipshits teenage girls who think they're smarter than they are go after. The Heathers do this like lunchtime poll, which apparently is something that everybody is afraid of somehow. It's some form of emotional terrorism. Veronica goes to ask JD this question.
You inherit $5 million the same day aliens land on the Earth and say they're going to blow it up in 2 days. What do you do?
And he says the most pretentious teen boy shit. He says,
probably row out to the middle of a lake somewhere, bring along a bottle of tequila, my sacks, and some Bach.
And Veronica's panties are like a Niagara. Whoosh. Yeah, her panties exploded. And like, watching it now, I remember when I first saw this when I was a teenager, I was like, whoa, he does seem like he's different than the other boys. But now as an adult, I'm like,
he's a sociopath. Run far away.
In a weird way, I always think the movie that the JD character isn't real. It's like that she conjures him as this like symbol of even the most popular girl has these dark fantasies that she has to wrestle with, where even though somebody may look like put together like a, you know, Tim Burton doll every day, that she's got this, you know, really angsty teenagery thing where she would just love to shoot up her school, and basically he's the vector for that.
Wow. Ooh, that is such a compelling theory. Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to think about this a lot more, that JD is just a figment of Winona Ryder's, or of Veronica Sawyer's imagination, and that he is her externalized, murderous, homicidal rage at the school and the people that she's surrounded herself with.
Yeah.
That makes a ton of sense. Let's talk about the morality of the different characters. who is the hero? Who are the real villains?
Betty Finn is the one true hero because she's so kind throughout. Every time that Veronica decides to descend from her throne to talk to Betty, Betty's like, thank you. Thank you so much. She pulls out pictures of the two of them as best friends when they were kids. I mean, she's the only person who has any sort of redeeming morality, I think, in the whole movie.
You know what? I'm going to say I think Martha is the hero because she's never cruel. She tries to end her life, but she survives. And then after that, she's able to forgive one of her prime tormentors, which I think requires so much more strength than any other character has to display. So I think Martha is the most heroic person there, but there's also a case to be made for Veronica, as awful as she is, having to fight this heroic battle against JD. Even though they're both bad, JD is more malevolent, and that she was, and Veronica was the one to defeat JD. She switches from this fucking guy to like the hero, which is her journey. Mm-hmm. Well, I love her. Her journaling monocle.
Mm-hmm. Oh. She has the journaling monocle. We need to bring those back. That is amazing.
It's a journaling monocle.
It's she not practical at all.
No, and she's always leaning way over the thing that she's journaling, but she's holding it in with her into her eye socket with her rage.
Yeah.
And she's, yeah. Okay, so JD is a this fucking guy for sure. Mm-hmm. Let's rank the Heathers, though. Okay, which Heather was the most evil Heather?
I think Heather Duke was the evilest because she was weak and mean. So she was so impressionable that she was doing everything that Heather Chandler told her to do. Go purge her, you know, lunch every day. And as soon as she had any Monaco power, she punched down. Whereas Heather number two was never vicious or mean.
Mm-hmm. No, she was also sexually assaulted and like her friend didn't stand up for her. So she's going through a lot of trauma.
Yeah. But she said, you know, when she found the swatch, she wasn't like, it's mine. She was like,
yeah, you're right.
She'd want you to have it, you know?
Right.
Heather number one, Heather Chandler, has some of the best, most hilarious lines in movie history.
Fuck me gently with a chainsaw. Do I look like Mother Teresa?
She said, real life sucks losers dry. If you want to fuck with the eagles, you have to learn to fly.
So good.
It's like a nonsensical sort of fever dream version of like if you were trying to conjure what the meanest thing a girl ever said to you was and just kind of mashed it together in a hodgepodge. It didn't quite make sense, but it was delivered with like laser cruelty. That is Heather number one. One of the best performances, I think, in a teen movie of all time. She is pretty much a monster, though, so she's also a this fucking guy, as much as I admire some aspects of her personality. Any final thoughts on Heathers before we break Hysteria Movie Club until next week?
I just can't believe that I was so hot and horny for JD when I saw it then, because I'm just like, ew. But I've dated that guy. You know,
ew.
I've dated that guy, and it's all smoke and mirrors. It's just pretentious, like, it's just pretentious.
That guy
trash.
Is the embodiment of a drink that's half milk and half orange juice.